The country's top cop urges police personnel to avoid getting entangled in illegal drug activities. PNP Chief General Benjamin Acorda Jr. says the decision of President Marcos to accept the courtesy resignations of some police officials allegedly linked to the illegal drugs or to illegal drugs should serve as an eye-opener to the police force. Acorda also says this proves government's determination to weed out rogue cops. In the meantime, Acorda says they continue to focus on rehabilitation and demand reduction in the country's anti-drug campaign. The Parañaque Integrated Terminal Exchange, or PITEX, has canceled bus trips heading to Mindoro due to Super Typhoon Egay. However, some bus routes have resumed operations. Robert Mano joins us on the line with the details of that. Robert?
Ron, buses traveling to Matnog Port in Sorsogon have been allowed to travel from the Parañaque Integrated Terminal Exchange Tuesday morning. Yesterday, around 20 buses were unable to travel, affecting almost 8,000 passengers. According to Jason Salvador, the spokesperson of PITX, operations are almost normal, but they are monitoring the situation, especially at the ports. As for Mindoro trips, they remain suspended, but PITX is keeping an eye on the latest developments and might lift the warning if conditions improved. Currently, there are no stranded passengers at PITX. And that's the latest, Ron.
Robert Mano with that story. Thanks.
More government aid arrives in the Philippine province of Batanes ahead of Super Typhoon Egay. The Social Welfare Department delivered 1,100 family food packs containing various food items. Batanes fisherfolk and residents also secured their boats after State Weather Bureau Pagasa warned a possible storm surge could cause flooding in the area. Pagasa earlier reported Egay may hit land or pass by Batanes or northern mainland Cagayan. Top leaders in Cebu satisfied with the second State of the Nation address of President Bongbong Marcos Jr. Cebu Governor Gwen Garcia said that the president gave a very comprehensive report on the gains of his administration. For Cebu City Mayor Michael Rama, the president's speech painted a hopeful tomorrow. Another official, Lapu-Lapu City Mayor Junard Chard, called the SONA a complete overview of government's accomplishments and challenges. Philippine economic managers vowed to curb inflation, which peaked at 8.7% early this year. To do this, government needs to improve food production and slash transportation costs. Jackie Pascual has details.
The economic managers of the Philippine government vowed to continue curbing inflation following the State of the Nation address of President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. The president has mentioned in his SONA that the biggest challenge of his administration is inflation, which peaked at 8.7% early this year, the highest in 14 years. At the post-SONA Philippine economic briefing earlier, National Economic and Development Authority Secretary Arsenio Balisacan asserted that the inflation rate is decelerating now, even hitting already 5.4% in June. He admitted, though, that prices of some products remain elevated, but some have already decreased. Government needs to improve production and lessen transport costs to lower prices, he said. The Philippine Chamber of Commerce and Industry President George Barcelon said that logistics is a major problem in the country and that leads to high cost of goods. And as Balisacan mentioned earlier, that they need to improve roads and farm-to-market roads so that your transport costs could be lower, which in effect could also lower prices of food. But for SM Investments Corporation Vice Chairman Tessie C. Coson, she said the issue of inflation is mostly because of external factors. And she admitted that it's tough to fight inflation in the country because, as she said, the Philippines is just one of the countries in the whole world that is also affected by inflation. The Banco Central ng Pilipinas said the target inflation by the end of the year is about 2 to 4%. BSP Deputy Governor Aquila mentioned also that they remain watchful and remains ready to resume monetary tightenings if needed.
The Philippine government is working swiftly to follow through on the order of President Marcos to combat smuggling and run after hoarders. In line with this, Justice Secretary Jesus Crispin Rimulya says they are looking into reports government officials are involved in agri-smuggling. Let's get more details now from ABS-CBN correspondent Mike Navallo. Mike?
Hi, Ron. Justice Secretary Jesus Crispin Remulla said earlier today the Department of Justice is verifying reports that government officials might be involved in the smuggling of agricultural products into the country. He said they are looking at certain names from different agencies that have something to do with giving permits for the entry of commodities into the country. Remulla said that among the agencies that DOJ will look into are the Bureau of Customs, the Bureau of Plant Industry, and other offices under the Department of Agriculture, which could influence the supply side of agricultural commodities. The BOC inspects imports of sedan in the Philippines, while the Bureau of Plant Industry issues import permits. Remulla said regulatory processes are important, and it's important to look into the government's own backyard first before investigating others. Remulla's statement came a day after President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. vowed during his second State of the Nation address to go after and prosecute smugglers and hoarders whom he accused of manipulating the prices of agricultural products. Remulla said the DOJ will form a fact-finding team within the next 2 weeks, which will conduct its probe for the next 1 to 2 months. While Remulla declined to provide a timetable for the filing of charges in court, he said they will try to rush whatever they can, but stressed the need to coordinate with various government agencies, such as the Bureau of Internal Revenue and the Securities and Exchange Commission. The BIR handles the collection of taxes, while all corporations are required to register with the SEC. Remulla claimed the smuggling of onions, garlic, and other agricultural products has been going on for 15 years, noting he saw a report as far back as 2008. Smugglers allegedly used recycled permits and other methods so they could illegally import goods into the country. Asked how much money is involved in bribing government officials, Remulla said it could run in the billions. The Justice Chief said those found responsible for smuggling could face many charges in court, including economic sabotage. And that's the latest, Ron.
Mike Navalio with that report. Thanks, Mike.